I mean, Ross said, enlightenment doesn't destroy your demons. It only makes them more clear. And I have never heard anyone execute my feelings so crystal. There are days when I get the feels so bad that going pee feels like a release I do not deserve. Nurturing self feels like an obligation. And it isn't until then I know I have not been serving from my overflow. A reminder that I have been neglecting to address self. But isn't that what we're taught? I am one, a black woman. Two, black. Three, a woman. Two and three, only because your political agendas constantly remind me that I'm supposed to separate the fight when I cannot separate self. But I digress. Four, queer. Five, educated. Six, poly. Seven, awkward. Oh my gosh, I am so awkward. In America, it feels and seems like being successful is defined by my ability to suppress all of these things. Taught to blend. Yes, I was taught well. I know how to eat, speak, dress, how to adapt to my surroundings, and don't forget, I know how to hide my feelings as a woman. This is the key to survival, and we are taught to survive, not taught to live. Living is a privilege, yet we are supposed to be free, but survival doesn't feel free. Little brown bodies don't have the privilege of being praised for being free. Our parents are still terrified that acting free will get us killed, and it does. And so we hide into ourselves, get our degrees, go to work, neglect our passions, feel stuck, bear children, relinquish our fears unto them, teach them how to adapt that passed down inherited fear we bestow upon our children if they were heirlooms. We are riddled with anxiety, but little brown bodies are taught to get over that shit. Because don't nobody have time for that shit. Who taught you that you have time to acknowledge anxiety and addressing your anxiety is a privilege? And who told you that you get a privilege? Being enlightened only makes this visible, makes the freight you carry clearer. This unwanted cargo, this work still has to be done so that you're not next to pass it on. And some days, that task seems daunting. Addressing self is an everyday process. Some easier than others, because I am and I will without having to force myself into categories that others will find easier to understand. There are days where being enlightened feels more like a burden, and I have to pull myself back up, crawling, crying, confessing, choosing to confront my ancestors, convicted in my belief, but I will, because I will live free under anything.
You might notice that we're in this beautiful, gorgeous venue, and they're so nice, they're so timed. So, that doesn't happen. Fuck it. All right, what you should do is this Saturday, this coming Saturday, you should come to Bye Bye Liver, the Twin Cities Drinking Play. Only one show left. It's the last one. It's a sketch comedy show featuring drinking games for the audience. So, if you enjoy the sauce, as I do, you should come here on Saturday. What time is that? What time is Bye Bye Liver happening? Seven? At 7 o'clock. 7 o'clock, be right here for a drinking game sketch comedy show. That's how I feel. Judges, 3, 2, 1, put up your scores, go! We got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. From low to high, I have an 8.0. Such a confused reaction. All right, an 8.1, an 8.2, an 8.4, an 8.8. We applaud the poet, not the score. Jewel, but up next, start clapping for your next poet on the stage. Bye, I'm